When it comes to color correction or color grading, one of the most important things you can do is look for consistency. When I'm doing my initial color correction, adjust clips to make them consistent from clip to clip, one of the things that I do more than anything is look back at the previous clip and then color the next one so that we get consistency. If you do color, I'm assuming you do the same type of thing because it's pretty common that you want to look at the clip before and then you want to look at the current one to make sure that they are consistent with each other. If you're a Final Cut Pro user, I think there could be one tool that you may have never even heard about that probably could be game-changing for consistency with color, and that is the comparison tool. This tool has actually been out for a while, but I think very few people actually use it. So I wanted to put together a quick video showing you why it is such a crucial and useful tool when you're color grading or color correcting your clips. So let's just say we're in the first stage of our color correction where we're just going through all of our clips and just color correcting them for consistency's sake, white balance, exposure, all those things. Normally what I would do is I would color a clip and then when I move on to the next clip, I would start to color that one and I would keep looking back and forth at the clip before it. That's very common and obviously the type of work that we do where you're looking and referencing the previous clip to the next one so you can go consistency. There's an even better way to do that. Let's just say I color corrected this clip. And for the sake of this, we're just gonna quickly just warm this up a little bit. In fact, what we'll do to even show it better is actually just make this super blue. Not that we're saying we want this to look like that, but so I can show you what a difference it actually makes. So if I wanted to start color grading this and trying to make it the same, and I tried to bring some blue into it and I tried to bring some contrast, and I kind of went down here and I went backwards just to check, and then I kind of make this a little bit more blue and I'm trying to just, you know, get it as blue as I can and try to get consistency. That's a lot of jumping back and forth and it ends up being kind of a little bit of a hassle. But there's this hidden tool in Final Cut. It's actually under Window, Go To, Comparison Viewer. What's really neat about this tool is that any clip you're on, the previous clip will actually show in the window right here next to you as a still frame. And what's great about that is you can adjust that window to make it any size you want, but now you can see in real time, I'm able to see side by side what the previous clip looked like, all its color schemes, all its looks, whatever. And it's very easy to just look at it and kind of get your match as close as possible. And it doesn't matter how many clips you have on this, it will continue to do that same thing. So as you can see, if there's a bunch of clips on here, if I'm color correcting this clip, there you see right there, the previous edit is right there. I can do my adjustments, whatever. As soon as I go to the next clip, bam, now it's showing the previous edit here. And then I can color correct and I can do whatever I want with this specific clip. You can also change this little button right here and go to next edit instead. So you can actually see when you're on a clip, it'll show the next edit rather than the previous. I personally feel like the previous is more useful because you're color correcting something, moving on to the next clip. So being able to see the previous one is more important, but you can change that as well. Now, there may be times that you're actually color correcting something and you're trying to make it match a previous edit or maybe even a YouTube video or maybe something that you just want to be able to have it side by side with it. You can also do that in Comparison Viewer. It doesn't have to just be in the timeline in the previous edit. So maybe you're doing your color correction here and you actually want to reference something else entirely, not just something that you specifically obviously had on the clip before. If you go in the top left-hand corner here, you'll see that you have two options. You have timeline and you have saved. And when you hit save, it'll allow you to actually save any frame from anywhere to actually make that useful. So I could go to another whole clip from another whole project, for example. Maybe I really like this clip in this specific spot and I can hit save frame and bam, it then saves that frame directly to there. And now no matter what I'm bouncing between in my timeline, you'll always see your saved frame. And you can continue to save more and more frames where you can actually look at any frame that you've previously saved and instantly reference it. So if I wanted to look back at a really old YouTube video, for example, where the color wasn't very good, but I could literally just bring up any one of these. And that way, as I'm editing, I can really quickly reference an old frame and you can save 30 different frames. And this is super useful if you actually do client work where you are maybe putting some new B-roll to an older edit, but maybe you use different cameras then or different color grades then or just a different process. It's really quickly to just put a few frames from that old thing in there and bam, you have these just instant references to something else that you used to work on. That saves you a ton of time. When you have this frame browser up, also you can go between a bunch of clips like this and just hit this little plus sign, and it'll actually just let you add a bunch of clips directly to that browser. So if you were looking through some of your favorite old vlogs or commercial work, whatever you have, you can just save a bunch of clips right in here. And then as you're doing your color correction at any given point, you can just pop up these different quick frames and instantly be able to make things happen. So as you can see, the comparison viewer is actually a super useful tool if you are doing any color grading or color correcting in Final Cut Pro. If you are brand new to color entirely, I highly suggest that you watch this video that I will link right here. And it's actually the whole color grade process, how to read scopes, and how I actually approach color as a whole. That's a good starter one if you've never gotten into color. But for those who already do a lot of color in Final Cut Pro, I'd be curious, do you even use that tool? Have you ever even heard of the tool? There are so many hidden tools and viewers and different things that you can do in Final Cut Pro I think a lot of people don't even know about. So I'd love to know, is this your first time hearing about it? I hope you found this video helpful. Make sure you smash that like button and hit subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. Comment below, tell me some things you'd like me to go over. I love tips, tricks, and ways to be more efficient and productive with your editing. So that's what I'm always trying to do. Thanks for watching.